Cowboys, Vikings on EA Sports. Getting ready to create problems for the opposing defenses in this matchup, Phil.
Man, when you're a quarterback, there is nothing like having a good tight end. Because you know why? Because he's close to you. So it doesn't take great skill for 6 yards from where you're at to a tight end who can catch it nowadays. And not only just catch the ball, get you about 10 or 15 extra yards running with it.
And with that kick, we're underway. Taken down, and he races out of bounds at that point. That return's good for about 21. First down at the 28. Toss to the outside. Barrels ahead. They are in on Peterson. And that's the type of run I think this offense would take all game long, Phil.
Oh, would they ever? They would love this. This is showing your dominance here. The offensive line doing a good job, but also a solid job by the running back picking up some good yards.
And he's taken down, but not until he picks up the first. The Vikings snap it at the 41. Finds his mark. And Claiborne's going to make the tackle. Okay, Phil, as we take a look at the offense, of course, Adrian Peterson will be the player to watch in this one.
Yeah, you got to watch him. He'll run you over. He'll run around you. This guy, hey, Jim, one of the best in the NFL. I think these linebackers are moving around because they're going to try to blitz the quarterback.
Is the one who made the big stop.
The Vikings put themselves in a tough situation here. On second down, you run the football, and what do? You lose yards. Now you got third and long coming up. You got to be careful in situations like this. Everything goes into the side of the defense.
The Vikings snap it at the 41. Got drilled as he throws it.
The Vikings don't have a lot of options on third and long situations. The pass goes incomplete, and the defense did a good job of staying back there and not giving up the deep throw.
And it's a fake. They're running a fake. And this goes incomplete as he was looking over the middle.
Well, anytime you run a fake punt and you let somebody throw the football besides the quarterback, even though the play is there and everybody's wide open, you still have a chance of not making it work. Why? Because the guy throwing it is not an NFL quarterback.
The Cowboys snap it at the 41. Almost made the catch, but the collision jarred it loose. He has has found a new home in Dallas, running back Darren McFadden.
Listen, he's tall. He can catch the football out of the backfield. He has great speed. Can the offensive line give him the opportunities? If they do, he is going to be great.
Darren McFadden will run with it. Rhodes is the one who brings him to the ground.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
The Cowboys will take the snap from the 35. Complete to Williams. First down at the 25. He's drilled as he throws. His presence felt today on that defense is Sharif Floyd.
Out of the University of Florida, he keeps getting better and better. He's very athletic, can really run for a defensive lineman, and he's going to be outstanding this year.
It's often the difference maker in any game, and that is how you perform inside the red zone, and we're getting an early taste of that.
No doubt about it, Jim. You got to be creative when you get in the red zone. We'll see what the offense calls.
And they are in on McFadden. Second and goal from the 5. Makes the catch. Touchdown. Still 3.5 quarters of football to play, but that touchdown gives them the lead here early.
Yeah, I know. There's a long way to go. There's no doubt it. But you gotta like your situation and the feel that your football team has getting that score and being on top.
The Cowboys getting ready for the kickoff. Sherrills fields the kick. The Vikings ready to take over again. They rolled the dice on their last possession, Phil, going for it on fourth down in their own territory. And, of course, they failed to convert.
Look, there's nothing like being aggressive. I like being aggressive, too, when I'm the coach of the team. But, listen, that was just uncalled for. When you're in your own territory, be smart, punt the football, and wait for the next opportunity.
We were both shaking our heads. What were they thinking about here?
Yeah, and saying some words that we can't say on the air. The defensive line, they're all shifting to the right. I think they're expecting a run.
Johnson's got it on the handle. Brought down at the 32. As we set now the defense, it'll be calling on a number of times today, cornerback Brandon Carr.
Every team on the defensive side needs a corner that can match up against the other team's best wide receiver. That man today is Brandon Carr.
As the first down and a whole lot more.
Defense is crowding the line of scrimmage. They're trying to confuse the quarterback.
First down at the 43. Pitchfork running away from the pressure.
Really good job that time by the quarterback. Nice. Get out of the pocket. Find some extra time to throw it. But look at the receivers. Well, look at the defenders all over the receivers down the field. There was nowhere to throw it.
Second down and 10. Bridgewater's taking off. Slides down.
It's not as easy as it looks. That quarterback, good job of sliding before he takes the hit that time. Wow, the D-line going into that spread look. They want to get to that quarterback.
And there's a drop.
That's a wonderful job that time by the secondary. Everybody's in position. Nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football. And it leads to another incomplete pass.
The Vikings this time will go with two tight ends.
Look at the linebackers moving around. They're trying to confuse the quarterback.
The Vikings will take the snap from the 40. He's averaging about 4 yards a carry. quick drop back. Bridgewater's now going to leave the pocket and tuck it under.
They've come out of the blocks fairly sluggishly, and this defense has taken full advantage, Phil.
Yeah, the offense having a tough time. They did not have a good series that time, and the defense pushed offense and got off the field.
Looks like they're going to go for it on 4th and 8.
They're trying to confuse the offense here. Look at everybody crowd the line of scrimmage.
The Vikings now move the chains, about to snap it for the 9th play of the drive. The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. With two hands, he has it. Touchdown, Minnesota Vikings. And that touchdown, Phil, here late in the first, ties the game.
Yeah, it ties it up, and it gets them out of a little hole. And, of course, it gives the offense a lot of confidence. And on the defensive side, they have struggled early, but maybe they can start to pick things up.
The Vikings getting set to kick it away. He's got a chance to return this one. And he's taken down right at about the 29, not quite to the 30.
The Cowboys offense taking the field again. They got everything they could out of that last possession, Phil. A solid touchdown drive.
Yeah, what a productive day so far for the offense. They're mixing it up well. They got confidence. The quarterback's throwing it well. This is a very good team so far. If you want to run the football with success, you're going to have plays like this where they pick up very little yardage. Don't listen to the fans. Keep running it, and it'll work.
The Cowboys will take the snap from the 30. Romo connects with Williams. Going to take it the distance. The 10, going to take it home for the touchdown. Early in the second quarter, and they've staked themselves to the lead with that touchdown.
Yeah, listen, don't start looking at that scoreboard, though. It's too early in the game. You just got to keep playing. Don't worry about winning and losing, but it's nice to be on top.
And the point after is good. The Vikings are ready to return the kickoff. Patterson's going to run this one out. And he's out across the 20 and tackled at the 21.
The Vikings offensive unit back onto the field here. Last time they had the ball, partner, they took it to the house.
Yeah, they were doing everything well, running and throwing the football like you said. And what do you do as a coordinator? You don't even know what to call because that play sheet, everything is working on it. Keep the momentum and keep this defense off balance.
Intercepted.
Good job that time by the defense. Not being fooled, being in position. When you're in position, you have a chance to make the play. That time they did, they got the interception.
Let's go. First down at the 37. And that'll be a gain of about 2. After running it, it's second down.
McFadden's a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short game.
And he's in for the touchdown. What a play. What a run.
It was a short route by the receiver. He catches it and goes all the way down the field and scores a touchdown. And the quarterback looks at the coach and goes, hey, it was a heck of a throw.
The Vikings are ready to return the kickoff. It'll be a touchback.
The Vikings offense back on the field, trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim. But you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go and go out there. Be aggressive and see if you can score some points.
First down at the 20. Bridgewater's on the move. Taking off. Ball is out. Nearly turning it over. It's second down. Peterson's lined up directly behind the quarterback here. Bridgewater's going to scramble.
Nice job that time by the defensive player. He is all over the receiver in this man-to-man coverage, and there was just nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football.
It'll be third down. On the move. He's got the catch. Huge yardage picked up and finally tackled at the end.
Well, a couple things on that play. Of course, it's a nice job by the quarterback getting out of trouble and throwing the football on run and getting the completion. But how about the defense? Quit being greedy. Stay in your rush lanes and don't let the quarterback get out.
At the line of scrimmage, the 41. It's a two tight end formation. The Vikings get a first down. They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Peterson's going to take the handoff now. Slashing to the right side. That last running play was good for only a yard, so it's second down and 9. Just a quick drop back. Has space. And he's tackled, but not until he picked up the first down. First and 10. Catches the ball on the sideline, but does not get both feet down. Second down following that incompletion. They bring in the extra tight end. He's hit as he throws it. At the 16-yard line. Here they come. Press coverage all the way. Third and 10. And he's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down. The offense is still on the field here on fourth down, needing six for the first.
Get ready.
The Vikings turn the ball over on downs.
The Vikings that time go for it on fourth down, and they fail. I did not understand the decision, but you got to make sure your team doesn't get down from that. You got to keep them up.
Off to Darren McFadden. That's a gain of only a yard. He's averaged about 2 yards a carry on the day. Well, we're anxious to hear the full story on that injury. Let's go down to Danielle Bellini with the story.
Guys, I just spoke with a Vikings official. They wouldn't specifically say what the injury was, other than it's an upper body injury that won't stop him from returning. Back to you.
Delay of game will cost them 5. After that penalty, it's now 2nd and 14. Second down and a long way to go. 2-minute warning. Third down now. Knocked down as he fires it.
The Cowboys really don't have much of a chance of picking up this first down. It's third long. Of course, the defense is looking for passes down the field. They're all over everything, and the pass goes incomplete.
Sherrills from the 27. Gains 12. The Vikings on offense, you'll remember the last time they were on the field, they faced that decision in opponent's territory and opted to go for it instead of kicking the field goal.
Yeah, I would think they're pretty motivated coming back out in the field, especially since they got nothing out of that last drive. I agree with the decision to go for it on fourth down. They just need better execution from the offensive players. Always try to save the timeout or timeouts when you can, and one way to do it is go to the hurry-up offense. Good job.
Breaks free, has some space to work with. Peterson's met at the 44. Wasting little time. First down at the 44. And Wallace got the catch and the first. First down at the 33.
Intercepted.
Ball is out. Recovery by the offense. And they are in on Peterson.
Nice job of the defense that time. In position, they read the quarterback's eyes, and it led to an interception.
The Vikings, and I have to wonder, where are they going to be mentally after that last drive when they were moving the football only to give it away on an interception? How are they going to be out there on this possession?
Well, I think it's tough. I really do, Jim. You know, nowadays, quarterbacks, it seems like all we judge them on, do they throw interceptions or not? And once you throw one, it's out there. You've got to get over that middle block, and you've got to keep playing hard and aggressive football. That's the only way you can have success. Good job of hurrying up and getting on that football and trying to get the play off. Don't use the timeout here. Good clock management. Snap that football.
They're going to the hurry. The Vikings take it from the 28. Makes the catch in the open field from inside the red zone.
Look out here. They're going to blitz. They're all packing the line of scrimmage.
Gets the handle here. Give that tackle to Sean Lee. The Vikings call a timeout. They're first. And it's now second down and 5 after running it on first down. Peterson. Lawrence is all over that offense and brings him down. The Vikings with a little uncertainty, so they take a timeout here before third down. A short field goal try on the way. The kick is good. And that will close out the first half from the Twin Cities. We'll step away for halftime and be back to Minneapolis in just a moment for the beginning of the third quarter. Just past the 20, we'll mark it at the 22-yard line. The Cowboys offense takes the field. Let's see if this momentum can carry over from the first half, because they have been brilliant.
Yeah, a lot of things change in that locker room at halftime. You know, you might feel good about what you've done. Of course, you've got to realize the defense might be upset and is willing to come out here and take more chances in the second half.
Second and 10 coming up. The Cowboys from the 22. And it's knocked down.
Well, I think it's important for the defense. Anytime it's a third and long situation for the offense to know where those first down markers are, give a little ground, and make sure you're able to come up and make the tackle short of the first down marker.
Tony Romo will take it right from the center. The Cowboys from the 22. And now Romo's going to take off. It's intercepted.
That was an awesome job by the defense. They just read the quarterback's eyes. They got in position, and they made the interception.
The Vikings talked things over at the intermission, and I'm sure one of the first orders of business was to try to figure out a way to get this offense going, Phil.
Absolutely. That's what you want to do, and I think you do that by play call. So the coach, they have many plays that we call drive starters. Catch the defense by surprise. They need to call one of those right here and right now to get this offense going.
He was looking short, but the pass falls incomplete.
There are a lot of ways to attack cover, too. You could go deep down the middle where neither the safeties are, or if a linebacker covers somebody deep down the middle, then throw it short underneath the defense.
Second down after the incompletion. Playing press coverage to the outside. Adrian Peterson takes the football. Good yardage picked up on that call.
Yep.
They hurry to the line of scrimmage. The Vikings will take the snap from the 40. The defense gets a sack.
Man, this defensive end, Jim, he is some talent. That time, good job, makes the move, shows the speed, and gets around there and gets the sack.
This will be second down.
Dagger! Dagger! You ready? Hey.
And it's batted down.
That time, the man-to-man coverage won. The quarterback had to make a perfect throw. He didn't. Incomplete pass.
We'll set up now at midfield. The Vikings get set at the line, needing to get to the 30 for a first. Looks like a penalty on the defense. After the penalty, the offense now is going up against a third and 16. This will be ruled incomplete. Didn't get the feet down.
The Vikings put themselves in a situation where the defense has all the advantage. They know the pass probably has to go down the field on third and long, and they were ready for it.
They're in punting formation. The fake is on, and they're looking to pick up the first.
Room to work.
And they bring him down at the 38-yard line.
Well, I love seeing plays like this. A fake punt, when you throw the football and it doesn't work, hey, it's easy to do these things in practice. But when you got to do it in the game, you can feel the pressure, you get tight, and sometimes you just cannot execute the play.
First down at the 38. Williams with the catch. Second down. They're in the hurry-up mode. Balls out. The defense has the football.
Keep two hands on that ball. Quarterback didn't do it, so when he's hit, that football came flying out.
Real good field position here to start this series. The Vikings retaking the field with their offense in a game that hasn't been very pretty here of late. Turnovers by both teams on the last two possessions.
Well, define the word pretty. I think if you ask the defensive teams, hey, they love this game. It's beautiful. So far, the takeaways by the defense, that's the story.
Looks like they're in press coverage here. The Cowboys with a nickel look here on defense. The Vikings have it at the 39. Toss to the outside. Now looking at third down. Wasting no time now for this next play.
When you see linebackers shifting around like this, what they're trying to do, confuse the quarterback.
Bridgewater's going to slide and avoid the hit.
Good job that time by the quarterback sliding. The team, you are valuable to them throwing the football, not running. Slide before you take that hit.
The offense is going to stay on the field now for this fourth and seven.
Tiger!
For this play, they'll go with two tight ends. The Vikings will take the snap from the 35.
Lee's able to show off those great hands and picking off that pass from the linebacker position. What a job and what a pair of hands.
The Cowboys will try to put a little drive together and not give the football away, Phil, as each team seems to like treat it like it's a hot potato.
Well, sometimes it is a hot potato. Did you know back in 1985, Jim, I set a record for fumbles in a football season? It wasn't easy to do, but I accomplished it with a lot of hard work, and I got it done.
Second and 10. And they're all over him for the sack.
Outside linebackers in the NFL, they are such tremendous athletes. They can do everything. How about that play that time? Good move, good speed, gets to the quarterback and gets a sack.
Witten's got it on a pass, had some heat on it. That's another reception, giving him two.
Good job by the offense picking up a first down there. They've been terrific all day long. They're winning the football game, and they are tiring this defense out.
Romo's completion percentage, 60% on the day. First down following the long play. Romo's going to throw once again on this down. Williams got it. First down.
Well, when you're playing this cover three defense where three defenders are playing deep, that's great. You stop the deep passes, but who's going to stop the quick ones? Well, nobody. That's why the quarterback and the receivers are having really good success throwing these slant patterns.
First down here after the completion. Coming up, second down. Complete. Touchdown.
Well, when you get close to the goal line, you always have to look out for the tight end, because anytime there's just a little bit of deception, that deception is enough for the tight end to get that area where he can get open. That time he does it. Touchdown.
The Vikings are ready to return the kickoff. Sherrill on the return. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. The Vikings offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim. But you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go and go out there, be aggressive, and see if you can score some points.
And the immediate handoff to the fullback. And it'll be second down and six after the running play on first down. They're going to the hurry-up offense, and they're back to the line quickly. Ridgewater's going to take off with it. He makes the catch. Down. The quarterback with the give to the fullback. Needing five to move the chains.
Good job by the defensive line, shifting all down inside. I think they're expecting a run up the middle.
The Vikings turn the ball over on downs.
Well, sometimes when you have a talented receiver, you just got to put up with plays like that. He might drop a few, but when he does catch it, it can make a big play.
This will probably be the last play of the quarter. The Cowboys take it from the 28. And it's swatted away. It's now second down. Tony Romo will take it right from the center. And the catch by Terrence Williams. We're back here in this lopsided game.
The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
Another takeaway. Tackle's made. This one is well out of reach, and that's more of a moral victory for this defense than anything else.
Well, it's a good moral victory. Anytime you get an interception, make the other team make a mistake, that is good for your defense. And, you know, I don't know. I don't think this game is over. I'm saying to the offense, let's see if you can go out there and score quick, and let's make a game of this.
The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. Looking long to Mike Wallace. Gets it out for the completion. That's his third catch of the day. First down here. The Cowboys sat at the line. Dime package. Some heat. No time to huddle now. First down at the 36. They're going to get him here for a sack.
Well, if I was that quarterback, I'd be mad. After getting sacked like that by the defensive end, your offensive tackle's just got to do a better job.
Loss of five on the play. The Vikings snap it at the 41. Take it down and sacked again.
Every defense is looking for somebody to hit the quarterback, and the best person to do it is the defensive end. What a good job that time by him.
Mike Wallace has the reception. They're going to go for it here on fourth and seven. The Vikings need to get to the 26 to get a first down. The Vikings take it from the 33. And Wallace there to catch the ball that had a lot of heat on it.
I can't give all the credit to the offense here. They go for it on fourth down here in the second half. Even though they're losing, the defense should have known
but that play was coming, and they should have stopped it.
Bridgewater's completion percentage, 50% on the day.
Dagger!
The Cowboys' defense packs it in now, going with the 46. First down at the 24. He's wide open for the grab.
Anytime your team is down, you're inside the other team's red zone, you look for one of your star players, your quarterback, wide receiver, or running back. They need to make a big play here.
First and goal. Has his man.
The offense is so close right here. They just need to show a little power and punch this in the end zone and get that touchdown.
Bridgewater's completed his last six passes.
Just a yard away.
Look at that. The defensive line, everybody shifting to the right.
And jams it across the goal line for the touchdown.
Defense is going to be mad about this. They were thinking run. They had the defense called. It was right. But they're not able to stop the surge.
A shining stone, ain't nothing in this life for free. Running from the greatest.